I was on the outskirts of a little southern town, trying to reach my destination before the sun went down. The old CB was a-blaring away on Channel 19, when there came a little boy's voice on the radio line. And he said, "Breaker 19, is there anyone there? Come on back, truckers, and talk to Teddy Bear." Well, I keyed the mic and said, "You got it, Teddy Bear." And the little boy's voice came back on the air. "Appreciate the break. Who we got on that end?" Well, I told him my handle. Then he began. "Now, I'm not supposed to bother you fellows out there. Mom says you're busy for me to stay off the air. But you see, I get lonely and it helps to talk. 'Cause that's about all I can do. I'm crippled and I can't walk." Well, I came back and told him to fire up that old mic, and I talked to him just as long as he'd like. "This was my dad's radio," the little boy said, "but I guess it's mine and my mom's now, because my daddy's dead. Dad had a wreck about a month ago. He was trying to get home in a blinding snow. Mom has to work now to make ends meet, and I ain't much help with my two crippled feet. She says not to worry, though, that we'll make it all right. But I hear her crying sometimes, late at night. You know, there's one thing I'd like more than anything else to see. Aw, I know you guys are too busy to bother with me. But you see, my dad used to take me for rides when he was home. But I guess it's all over now since my daddy's gone." Not one breaker came on the old CB as that little crippled boy talked with me. I tried hard to swallow the lump that just wouldn't stay down as I thought about my little boy back in Greenville town. Dad was gonna take Mom and me with him later this year. Why, I remember him saying, "Someday this old truck will be yours, Teddy Bear. But I know I'll never get to ride an 18-wheeler again. But this old base will keep me in touch with all my trucker friends. Teddy Bear's gonna back on out now and leave you alone, 'cause it's about time for Mom to be coming home. But you give me a call when you're passing through, and I'll sure be happy to get back to you." Well, I came back and said, "Before you go, 10-10, what's your home 20, little CB friend?" Well, he gave me his address, and I didn't once hesitate, 'cause this hot load of freight is just a-gonna have to wait. I turned that old truck around on a dime, headed straight for Jackson Street, 229. And as I rounded the corner, oh, I got one heck of a shock. 18-wheelers were lined up for 3 city blocks. Why, I guess every driver for miles around had caught Teddy Bear's call, and that little crippled boy was having a ball. For as fast as one driver would carry him in, another would carry him out to his truck and take off again. Well, you'd better believe I took my turn at riding Teddy Bear. Then I carried him back in and set him down in his chair. And buddy, if I never live to see happiness again, I want you to know I saw it that day in the face of that little man. We took up a collection for him before his mama got home. Then all the drivers said goodbye and they were gone. He shook my hand with a mile-long grin and said, "So long, trucker, I'll catch you again." Why, I hit that old interstate with tears in my eyes. I turned on the radio and I got another surprise. "Breaker 19," came a voice on the air. "Just one word of thanks from Mama Teddy Bear. We wish each and every one a special prayer for you, 'cause you just made my little boy's dream come true. I'll sign off now before I start to cry. May God ride with you." 10-4.